Alrighty guys, we're gonna get started. Sorry about the first video if you're on that one. One, it was really shaky at the beginning, this one's really shaky. It kept blurring out, so hopefully it's not doing that right now or it doesn't do that later. But yeah, grab a detergent bottle, like I said. Hopefully it's kind of full. Or grab a dumbbell if you have one for a little bit of heavier weight. But whatever one works. If you didn't see the little note, it also said 10 to 20 pounds. It kind of depends on what you're comfortable with and, you know, the movement. But we're going to start by warming up. Today we have a total of like 6 movements we're doing 1 minute of, and then we're going to run through that 3 times. First, we're going to go ahead and do jumping jacks for 30 seconds. We're going to do the cross jacks. You cross your feet, cross your hands at the same time, and go. Alrighty guys, go ahead and go into some butt kickers. Alrighty guys, next one we have is the skiers. Remember, you're dipping down, opposite arms touching the floor to the opposite leg, and then you're hopping back over, back and forth. Alrighty guys, go ahead and go down the floor. Feet on the floor, feet in the air, whatever you want to do. We're going to do crunches for 30 seconds. And go. Alrighty guys, last one, flip it on over. We're gonna do shoulder taps, 30 seconds. Alrighty, and go ahead and get some water. We're going to run through that one more time, and then we'll start on the actual workout. Alrighty guys, go ahead and stand it on up. Remember, we have our cross jumping jacks first for 30 seconds. Alrighty guys, next we got our butt kickers. Alrighty guys, skiers next. Alright guys, down on the floor, and we have our crunches. Alrighty, last one, we have our shoulder taps. Alrighty, and time. Go ahead and grab some water. I'm gonna start some music. Hopefully you can hear it. And then we will get going on everything else. Alrighty guys. Sweet. Alright, so like I said, we have 6 movements if I can count correctly. The first one we're doing is going to be a thruster to squat jump. We've done this one before. So basically you guys are going to start in a push-up position. You're going to go thruster up to squat. Squat jump, jump back to your push-up position, and then come back up to your squat jump. So it's kind of like you're doing a burpee, just no push-up, so it's like a plank burpee. But really emphasize that you're doing the squat jump, and make sure you're keeping your chest up when you get into that squat position. Don't keep it hunched over, it's going to start bugging your back. But yeah, we're going to do each one of these for a minute. I'll go through each movement as we bump down, you guys will have breaks in between, that kind of thing. So let's get going with these in 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. Next we have plank hold, regular hold, forearm plank hold. So 1 minute total. We won't do 30 seconds each side. Alrighty. So 3, 2, 1, and go. We got 15 seconds. Alrighty, and time. Sweet. So while you guys rest, I will explain the next one. So the next one's gonna be like a single leg deadlift to a hop back. So I think we've done single leg burpees before. It's similar with the hop. We're not jumping though. So what you're gonna do, you just keep your arms to your side. You're gonna go on one leg. It's gonna be slightly bent like when you do a deadlift. So you're gonna deadlift down. Okay, once you get about this low, hands on the floor, hop back, hop forward, stand it on up. So same movement as when we do regular deadlifts. We barely bend our knees the whole way. We're pretty much hinging our hips down, or forward I should say, to where you're feeling the burn in your hamstrings, not your quads. So we're gonna do single leg deadlift, hop back, hop forward, stand it all the way up before you start your next one. We're gonna go 30 seconds each side. They're gonna go a little slower, but make sure you focus on your form so you're not just too wobbly, that kind of thing. So yeah. So we will start in 3, 2, 1, and go. I want you guys to get a good number in, so I'm going to actually go over 30 seconds, so just keep going. Alright, you guys, switch legs. Alrighty, and time. So I did 45 seconds for each leg. I just based on how many I got done, I want you guys to get done about the same amount. I think 30 seconds would be a little too quick. So we'll do 45 seconds each leg. This next one we're doing, we've done it before. Feet together. You guys just have center squats. Remember to keep your chest back. Your butt and hips are supposed to be pushing back. Make sure your knees aren't going over your toes, as you know. So 3, 2, 1 and go. Alrighty guys, and time. Sweet. Go ahead and get some water. Next one, we have two more. Three more. First one's gonna be detergent sit-ups. So regular sit-ups. Either hold your detergent bottle as such, or dumbbell obviously hold it like this. Use whichever you want. I'm gonna use the dumbbell just because it's a little heavier because my detergent's almost empty. So I hope yours is it. So detergent sit-ups, basically feet in front of you. Weight is gonna go above where your eye level is. You're gonna sit up and lift your weight above your head. So your weight's staying in front of your eye level the whole time until you come up and then it goes over your head and then back down. So yeah, we're gonna do that for a minute. 1, 2, 3, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. Sweet. Again, while you guys rest, I will explain. This next one's kind of funky. So it's very similar to whenever we've done kettlebell swings before, except we're adding a squat within the kettlebell swing. So basically, again, grab your dumbbell, hold it like this, like it's a goblet kind of, or this is a goblet, but hold it downward with your fingers. If you have a detergent bottle, just hold it both hands down. I'll demonstrate this one because it's the weirder one to hold. So basically, you're going to start like you're hiking a football. Go ahead and rock it back. When you come forward, this is your regular kettlebell swing. For this one, we're going to do kettlebell swing. When you get to the bottom, you're going to then drop down to squat and then put it down in front of you. So again, we're going to go kettlebell swing, go back, drop down, come back up. So this little back part is always your intermediate before you drop down or before you go forward. So either way, the weight's going in front of your face. Either you're going to do the squat first, so squat, and then the kettlebell swing, squat, and then the kettlebell swing. It's important that at the top of the swing, you're squeezing your butt. At the bottom of the squat, you're keeping your chest up, so make sure you're not still leaning forward. I know with the kettlebell swing, we're hinging your hips. You don't want to hinge your hips only when you're doing the squat because you want your chest to be up and you're actually wanting to squat and using your butt and your glutes. So we're going to do that for a minute. If you feel uncomfortable doing the squat, don't do it. Just do the kettlebell swing or take it slow so you can get the motion going and then you can start combining them all. So go ahead in 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty, and time. Remember on that back swing, whenever you're changing between the squat and the kettlebell swing, you want a slight bend in your knees. You don't want your legs to be straight. So just like when you're doing kettlebell swing, you have that bend. You still want that bend. The only time your legs are gonna be straight is at the top of your kettlebell swing when you're squeezing your butt. So last one, we've done these ones before, just a hand release push-up. Remember at the bottom, you're releasing your hands, lifting them off the floor. I kind of lift my feet too, and then you're engaging back up. So you're kind of disengaging your muscle each time. Try not to use it as a little hop off, but really kind of just use your muscles to pull yourself up, keeping a tight core, so you're not kind of dragging your stomach like a seal. So let's go in 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. That does it for round one. Next round, I promise I'll do a lot less talking. You'll still have your breaks in between though. And then we're just gonna start with our thruster squat jump. Alrighty guys. Let's get going in 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. Sweet, next we got our plank hold. Use this one to breathe. I know I need to. Sweet. Alrighty guys, 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. Awesome, next we have our single leg deadlift to our hop back. I thought the plank hold would be a break from legs, and then I realized how much I had to squeeze my legs, and that didn't help. Let's get going. 3, 2, 1, and go. Remember, we're doing 45 seconds each side. I will tell you when to switch. Just Try to get one more in. All right, you guys, switch legs. Alrighty, guys, one more. Alrighty, next we have, oh, center squats, not sit-ups yet. Alrighty, guys, let's get going in 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty, guys, and time. Sweet, grab your weight. Next we have our detergents or dumbbell sit-ups. Alrighty, guys, 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty, guys, and time. Alright, next we have our squat to kettlebell swing, or kettlebell swing to squat. Remember, grab your dumbbell or your detergent bottle for this one. Alrighty, guys, 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty, guys, and time. Sweet, we have our last one. It's gonna be a hand release push-ups. After this, we have one more round, then we're good to go. Alrighty guys, let's get going in 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. Sweet. Get some water, one more round, and then we are good to go. God bless the shade, or else I'd be dying. Alrighty guys, we're gonna get going in a few seconds. Ready, 3, 2, 1, and go. We got our thruster to squat jumps. Try to get 2 more in. Alrighty guys, and time. Alrighty, get ready for plank hold. Alrighty guys, 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. Alrighty, next we have our single leg deadlift to hop back. Again, 45 seconds. Alrighty guys, get ready. 3, 2, 1, and go. Try to get one more in. Alrighty, I switch legs. Alrighty guys, one more. Sweet. All right. Next we have our center squats. All right, 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. Down on the floor, grab your dumbbells and or detergent, not and, or detergent bottle, and we're gonna do our sit-ups. Alrighty, 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. Go ahead and get your weight ready for your kettlebell swing to squat. When I'm doing these, I always get worried that when I swing up, my hands are gonna be too sweaty and I'm gonna let go of the kettlebell or the dumbbell. It'd be a bad day. Alrighty, 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. One more thing, we have our hand release push-ups. Go ahead and take a sec, then we will begin. For these ones, I didn't really mention, doesn't really matter. You can do regular push-ups, you can do tricep push-ups. Those are my personal favorite. You can do wide arm, it's kind of harder because it's awkward. But yeah, I like tricep a lot, especially if you're more used to just doing them with your elbows going out, keeping your elbows more to your side. It's a really good workout. It's kind of a different different variation of push-up. So it just works different muscle groups, aka your triceps. So I encourage you to try it if you haven't before. They're pretty fun. But We're gonna get going in 3, 2, 1, and go. Alrighty guys, and time. That does it for the rounds. Go ahead and stick around with me to stretch. So go ahead, right arm over the chest, pull into that elbow, and switch sides. Alright, right arm up over the head, pull into the elbow. And switch. Go ahead and grab your fingers or interlace your hands behind your back, and then go ahead and bend it forward. You can do the standing too. Alrighty, and if you're not already, stand it on up. Go ahead and get into your straddle down to your left side. Alrighty, switch sides. And down the middle. Alrighty, go ahead and sit it down, feet facing each other into your butterfly stretch. And then push one knee down at a time. Alright, drag those feet out in front of you to where you're in a diamond and then bend it forward. Alrighty guys, stand it on up for me. Grab your right leg, pull your butt or your heel to your butt, and then go into your quad stretch. And switch sides. Alrighty, you know how I'm going to end this. Nice deep breath in. On the exhale, bend it back as far as you feel comfortable. And stand it back up. Alrighty, one more inhale. Exhale down to your toes. Sweet. Thank you for joining me. I hope I see you guys again soon. I don't know when we're starting classes. No one does. But yeah, hopefully I can see you guys in person. I know I say that every week, but yeah, it'll happen soon. But yeah, I'll see you guys next Wednesday. Again, drop in the comments anything you want to see. Hopefully I'm going to do a partner workout soon. You don't need a partner. I could be your partner, but it'll be a little bit different. So I just have to get someone to do it with me. But yeah, have a good day, and I'll see you guys soon.